everybody. Hola a todos. Aquí estoy con mi mamá. Diga hi, mom.
Hi.
Y estamos ahorita en la placita Olvera, ¿verdad, mamá? Enfrente.
Sí.
¿Y qué estamos haciendo?
Va a haber un memorial de mi tía Cruzita Moreno. Enseguida de. En la plaza Casa de la Arte y Cultura. En Los Ángeles, y ahí es donde vamos a estar ahorita. Está reunida toda la familia, mucha familia que no conocemos y mucha familia que conocemos también. Y vamos a estar ahí mirando, pienso yo, que es la historia de la vida de mi tía Cruzita Moreno. En el lugar donde está ubicada la Casa de Arte y Cultura de Los Ángeles, muchos años atrás estuvo la panadería La Esperanza de mi tía Cruz y mi tío Ezequiel Moreno, su esposo. Entonces ahí ese lugar lo cambiaron, lo quitaron, el frente, la fachada de la panadería, y la pusieron en el Museo Smithsoniano. Entonces ahora ahí está la Casa de Arte y Cultura de Los Ángeles, y ahí es donde se va a hacer el memorial. Bueno, esta es la iglesia de Los Ángeles. Ajá. Pero aquí acaban de terminar un evento que hubo. Nosotros acabamos de llegar, nosotros no vinimos a la misa, pero vamos a estar en el memorial.
Y so ahorita vamos para la Plaza de la Cultura.
Casa de Arte y Cultura.
Oh, okay.
De Los Ángeles.
Y ahí es, pensamos que van a hacer como un slideshow de fotos y van a hablar de la familia,
de la vida de mi tía.
¿Tía?
Mi tía que murió el año pasado, la recogió el Señor.
Pero como estamos en pandemia, pues no se pudo hacer nada, ¿verdad?
Sí, entonces ahora lo estamos haciendo. Y mi tía iba a cumplir a...
Siento.
Varias veces
ahí. Sí. Bueno,
Es una foto de mi tía Cruz. Sí, ¿verdad?
We got some lovely Mexican.
Oh, thank you.
Qué delicioso se ve.
¿El mole?
El mole.
También, por favor, un poquito de mole.
Está riquísimo.
Mole poblano.
¿Chimichanga?
Gracias, thank you.
Mole poblano aquí. ¿Ah? Carne con nopales, frijol y arroz y una quesadilla, una chimichanga.
Chimichanga.
Aquí está mi mamá y mi primo John. Hi, John.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay, so this is my great aunt. She, her and my great uncle opened up this bakery here in Los Angeles called La Esperanza back in the 1920s, 1930s. She, on her 105th birthday, received a letter from President Obama and Michelle Obama, signed, wishing her a very happy birthday. And they wished her an excellent success because they took a piece of the history, the sign of La Esperanza Bakery. It now sits at the Smithsonian. It was dedicated there and it sits there. It's gonna be there for about 10 years. So it's a great piece of history.
Thank you, John. Ahí salió en la foto, madre. Ahí está en la foto. En la de arriba, ¿la ve?
Oh, sí, ahí está.
Yeah.
yo te quiero.
Ah, no, él siempre se cansó.
Otro amor así. Qué bueno.
Ajá.
So here's Alexa.
Qué lejos estoy del suelo donde nací.
My name is Angelica, and I am one of the first generation of Moreno grandchildren. I believe there are now six generations. Today we celebrate the life of our grandmother Cruz Moreno, and it is quite fitting that we are on the site where the family restaurant once stood and was established in 1918 by our grandfather Ezequiel Moreno. It was Cruz and Ezequiel's life's work and a legacy they left us of early Los Angeles history. We would like to thank La Plaza de Cultura y Artes and CEO John Echeveste for allowing us to honor Cruzita in such a meaningful way. In addition, I'd like to thank Dr. William Estrada of the National History Museum, who has been so supportive and contributed to documenting the history of Los Angeles, and specifically La Plaza and La Esperanza. My earliest memories of Cruzita was at our annual family Christmas parties. To this day, all of us cousins reminisce fondly the fun in taking over the grounds of our grandparents' home in Bradbury. There were children everywhere, chasing each other, playing, exploring the landscape, and sometimes spotting snakes and deer. All the adults, our parents, socially gathered in the rumpus room, indulging in a little wine or drink, and laughing and sharing stories. Grandpa and Cruzita were the center of attention. Cruzita was not the typical grandmotherly type. She was a businesswoman, a role she gained when she married Ezequiel. Together, they worked tirelessly, early morning to late nights, building the family business, La Esperanza. It became a favorite eating spot for customers who came from far and near to enjoy the food and pan dulce. During weekdays, the county workers came. I recall County Sheriff Peter Pitches was their friend, which was a benefit when Grandpa got traffic tickets. On Sundays, there was always overflow crowds who had attended Mass at La Placita Church. Hollywood and TV movie stars came to enjoy the delicious menu. Both Cruzita and Grandpa Ezequiel were pillars of the community of La Plaza. They were among the founders of the Cámara de Comercio Mexicano. Grandpa was the presidente and Cruzita was first lady of the organization. They belonged to the Comité Cívico Patriótico, which sponsored the yearly Grito and 16th of September festivities in Los Angeles. They fully participated in several charities and philanthropic organizations. After the closure of La Esperanza and the death of Ezequiel, Cruzita continued to persevere in her charitable work and organizations like the Casa de Cuna, an orphanage in Tijuana they sponsored, and she worked at the Southwest Museum, where she taught Mexican cooking classes and she catered events in the community. She loved to travel and often took trips to her beloved Mexico and to Europe, Spain, Italy, Israel. One year, she joined me and friends on a trip to Argentina and Brazil for the Carnaval. She was definitely a free spirit and continued to travel into her 90s. It was in this past 10 years that we visited Cruzita at Santa Teresita Nursing Home that I came to understand how her life circumstances shaped her life. She often spoke of the loss of her mother at a young age and then her father, with whom she had a special bond. She said she was his consentida, the favored one. And after his untimely death, it was her older brothers and sister Lola who took over the responsibility to care for her. She often told stories of Lola giving her many household chores to do and sending her to the river to wash clothes. The Rio Lerma was a large river that she described ran in front of their home. And she talked about sneaking out to the river taking swims across the River Lerma. She spoke to her of her brothers Enedino, David, and Benjamin, who worked in the mine, coming home and spoiling her. And then, as a young woman at about age 18, beginning a new life in California. She became an independent, industrious, and hardworking woman who never stopped. She just kept going and going and working and working. In her last years living at Santa Teresita Nursing Home, the Carmelite sisters and all the staff and residents loved her, and they provided her with wonderful care. When the dementia began to set in her mind, she was still working. The staff became the waitresses and the waiters of La Esperanza. She criticized the food and the presentation, And when she was pleased, she gave them tips, and she made sure they brought her the bill to sign up for the meals. What a wonderful full 100 years, almost 108 years she led. And we, whose life she touched, are much better for it. Thank you.
I'm Leonor, and I'm, as my cousin Eddie Boy says, the matriarch of the family now. But I just want to thank you all for coming. I really appreciate your presence here and the love that you're showing our family and Cruzita, and honoring her in this celebration of her life. And I want to give a special thank you to Santa Teresita, the manor, for all their loving care. It truly is a place of caring.
Your grandma, great grandma, for a long time. And yes. One day, it was getting close to Christmas, and I said, "Could we learn to make the males?" She said, "Certainly." So I got a group of people together and we went down. And so she had me there first. And she gave me the stuff to make the sauce, or not the sauce, but what is it, the pasta?
Masa.
Masa. And so she is saying, okay, use your hand. I said, okay, and I'm in there doing this, like this forever for about 3.5 hours before I dropped it in something and actually came up with the top. You have to do that. And I said, you're going to do that? No. She gets out from under the cupboard. She gets out an electric mixer. I said, thank you so much. Anyway, it was wonderful. That's just one of millions of memories I have of her. She was an important person to all of us. And she changed, she really made differences in people's lives. So you're very lucky to have her as part of your family. Thank you.
Thank you.
Porque me dijo, here, get the, me dijo, toma las fotos y ponlo en el teléfono. Ok, me tomé una selfie. She opens up her phone, she's gonna find a picture.
Es la foto
mira,
aquí estamos en la tiendita de la Casa de la Cultura y Arte de Los Ángeles. Pase. Y aquí antiguamente era el restaurante de la panadería La Esperanza, el restaurante y panadería La Esperanza.
Y ahora es un... ahora es la tienda.
Y... pan. De La Esperanza.
Esta es la Plaza de la Cultura, que antes era el restaurante y panadería.
Bueno amigos, familia de YouTube, quiero darles gracias por estar viendo este video. Si te gustó este video, la historia de nuestra familia, de mi tía Cruz, asegúrate de ponerle un like a este video, suscríbete a mi canal para ver más videos interesantes. Gracias, esto es el final de este video. Gracias por acompañarnos al Memorial Service de mi tía Cruz. Solo un summary. Ella y su esposo Ezequiel Moreno fundaron un restaurante y panadería aquí en el centro de Los Ángeles, aquí en la Placita Olvera, donde ahora es la Plaza de la Cultura. Y voy a ver si puedo poner un link abajo en la cajita de descripción descripción para que ustedes puedan leer un poco más de la información sobre la vida de ellos y sobre el restaurante y panadería de ellos. Muchas gracias por acompañarnos y no se te olvide de ponerle like a este video y suscríbete, deja cualquiera de tus comentarios abajo. Gracias y feliz día. Hasta pronto.